we will know about the green revolution. What is green revolution? When a large increase in crop production is achieved by using artificial fertilizers, pesticides, high yielding crop varieties, that is known as green revolution. So when the crop production is increased by the use of artificial fertilizers, pesticides, irrigation, high yielding crops, this is known as green revolution. Now we have to know about the green revolution in India. So green revolution in India refers to the period when Indian agriculture was converted into an industrial system due to the adaptation of modern methods and technology, such as the use of high yielding variety of seeds, tractors, fertilizers, etc. So when by using the modern method and technology, the Indian cultivation system is changed in that way that the total production is increased. This is known as green revolution in India. And generally, the green revolution in India was started in the year of 1965, and it was decided and it was an initiative of the government of India, and at that time the Prime Minister of India was Mrs. Indira Gandhi. And the green revolution was applied from the period of 1967, and it was up to the year 1978. The green revolution was most effective in the area like Punjab, Haryana, and some parts of Uttar Pradesh. And the effect of green revolution was concerned with mainly the wheat and the rice cultivation. And Dr. M. S. Swaminathan, who led the green revolution in India, that's why he is known as the father of green revolution in India. And he introduced the high yielding variety of seed of wheat, high yielding variety of wheat in India. And that's why he is known as the father of green revolution in India. So M. S. Swaminathan is known as the father of green revolution in India for his role in the green revolution in India. He introduced the high yielding variety of wheat in India. And so what are the methods which are used in green revolution to increase the production of the crop? Some methods are used in green revolution. The first one is the double or multiple cropping system. That means within a year, different type of crops or more than one of crops were cultivated in the same piece of land. The second thing is that the seeds which are used in cultivation, that is with superior genetics. And the third one, proper irrigation system. So for cultivation, this is very important. For farming, it's very important to watering, to give water to the plants, so to the crops. So proper irrigation system is also used in green revolution. Number four is that high yielding variety of seeds of wheat and rice was introduced in India, and pesticides, fertilizers are also used to increase the production of the crop. Tractors, harvesters, this type of modern machineries and technologies are also used in green revolution. And try to increase the farming areas. So the area of farming is increased by converting the wasteland, fallow land into the farming land. And as a result, we can see that during the year of 1950 to 1960, India was not self-sufficient in food production. But just after late 1960 or from the year of 1917, there is a huge increase in the production of wheat and rice. And after that, India became self-sufficient in the food production. So this is very important role of Green Revolution in Indian economy, that India became self-sufficient in food production after 1970. So what are the advantages of Green Revolution? The advantages are that by using the high-yielding seeds, the total production increased up to 3 times. And another is that by multiple cropping, also the total production is increased. And as a total production increased, the surplus production is there. So the farmers can sell the surplus product, and by selling the surplus product, they gain profit, by which they can improve their standard of living, their life is changed, and as they have money from the surplus production, by this they can purchase the fertilizers and machineries for the future days. And the most important advantage of Green Revolution is that India became the self-sufficient in food grain. So after Green Revolution, India became the self-sufficient in food production. These are the main advantages of Green Revolution. So from this video we understand that Green Revolution is that where by using modern method and technology, the production is increased. And in India, it was started in the late 1960s. And the father of Green Revolution was Mr. M. S. Swaminathan. And the advantages of Green Revolution, the most important advantage is that India becomes self-sufficient in food production after the Green Revolution. And the Green Revolution was mainly seen in the areas of Punjab, Haryana and some parts of Uttar Pradesh. Okay, that's all. Thank you.